Hello everyone, welcome to RTL Learnings, and in this video we're going to see what is slow step and execution trial and open log and log activities in Power Studio debugging concepts. And we have already completed the part one of debugging concepts. If you haven't watched that, please go back and watch that video first and then come to this particular video. And before going to see these topics, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please consider subscribing for more videos. And if you like this video, please give it a like. And if you have any other doubts, please do mention them in the comment section below, or any other suggestions are mostly welcome. Just do comment them in the comment section below. So in the part one, we completed what is step into, step over, step out, what is the restart option, ignore, retry, and the breakpoints on the locals panel, where we can see the arguments on the variables. What are the arguments and variables that are present in the workflow? And in this video, we're going to see what is slow step, execution trial, log activities, and open logs in the debugging ribbon. So firstly, let me create a flow here, which is, let me take a message box over here, and then another message box. So I think two are sufficient here, Aditya Learnings. And here it is Aditya. So how this slow step option works here, we can read the debug at slower speeds, from the slowest 1x to the fastest 4x speed, using highlight to monitor each step of the execution. So if it is normal, it is off. If it is 1x, if I click on debug, the execution is will work in a 1x speed. So you can see that it is going slowly to the one step to the other step. This is what slow step is all about. If I take 2 and debug again, so it is going a bit faster now. So it is 3x now. So it is moving faster. So if it is 4, let us check for the 4 as well. So remove this toggle breakpoint here. And now it is in the 4x speed. So it is came too much faster than the 1x. So this is how, when you are debugging a big workflow, you want to see step by step process whether what it is happening, then you can use this slow step option to see each and every step. And this is all about the slow step in the debug ribbon. And what is execution trial? Execution trial is nothing but it will give you an indication whether that particular sequence or the activity is performed correctly, or the activity is performed without any errors. If there is an error, it will show you then error mark, red color alert. If it is passed successfully, it will give you a green tick. And if it is waiting to be completed, it will show you a timer option, orange color timer option. So let us see how it works. If I click on debug here, I'm not enabled the execution trial, so let me enable it first. So click on this execution trial, it will enable the execution trial. If I click on debug now, first it will go to the debugging sequence here, and then it will come to the message box. So now it is actually partially executed. The sequence is partially executed because the activities is not executed correctly. So it is partially executed, which shows this timer option. If I click on OK, this particular activity is successfully executed. So it will give us the green tick stating that this particular activity is executed. There is no error in this particular activity. And if I click on OK, then it will show this particular executed activity symbol here. So if there is an error, then it will show us the red color symbol, which we usually see when there error occurred in the UiPath Studio. So this is all about the execution trial in UiPath Studio and what are log activities. So here you can see when we actually process this particular simple workflow here, there is only two steps which is written on the output panel, which is the execution is started and the execution is ended, but there is no information for us this particular activity is executed and this particular activity is not executed. So when we click on this particular log activities, it will log each and every activity which is in the process where it is executing. So if I click on debug now, it will log each and every activity which is executing in this particular output panel. So we can see here it is the debug is started now, the execution is started, and you can see the main is executing now. After that it is debugging, executing. After that it is, it will execute this particular message box is executing, and then message box is closed because the first message box is closed, so it is giving us the first message box is closed, and this is the second message box, so it is also closed. So you can see the executing here closed, debugging closed, and the main closed. This is a thread that is closed from the main is executing and the main is closed, debugging is executing and debugging is closed. This is the use of our log activities here. If you enable this one, you can see all the activities which are performing in your particular process. And then what is log active open logs, and here you can also open logs by pressing Ctrl L. Let me just keep a log message here, I will tell you what's the requirement of keeping a log message here, so that it is a log. So let me run this again, debug this again. Whenever we are actually processing a workflow and didn't know whether which activity got failed and you need to check back later at later times, then you cannot see in this particular output, because if let us take a scenario, if the bot is scheduled at every 1 hour and the first hour it is got successfully executed and there is no errors, and the second hour it got failed and you didn't see why it failed, and the third hour it is executed successfully, and the fourth hour it is again got failed, and you really don't know what's the reason, because the next time it is executing it will clear the output panel here, because there is no output panel when we run in unattended mode, but in attended mode there is no output messages that has which is failed. So to check that particular output results, you will either click on this or click on Ctrl L, which will take you to this file explorer where you can see the logs, and here you can see this is a date, today's date, log message date is the execution log, this is the execution log, and this is the studio log. There is two logs, which is execution log and the studio log, and the if we click on execution log, here you can see all the processes of the activities which are run for that day. And here you can see now here you can see it is started, the execution is ended here. So where is the execution started? I think it is somewhere around okay, where is this started? Here it is ended. Where is our log message? It is main closed, debugging closed, message box closed, message box executing. Here you can see it is a log message, and the log message that we kept there, here it is, it is a log. Here we can see it is a log, the log which I have written. And whenever you are processing two three workflows, invoking two three workflows, if you want to know whether that particular if the process came to that particular step, then if you just simply give a log message there, then you can see up to where it is taken. Now it is there in this particular workflow. If it is executed, then up to that it is executed perfectly. After that it may be gone wrong, and it is not executed perfectly, then that is the exemption. And here the process Aditya is execute is actually started, and here you can see message box is executing, debugging, executing, main executing. Here it is started, execution started here. These are the steps that we got in this particular run. So this is how actually logs will be more useful for us in while debugging the process or testing the process on that while testing our automation flows. This is all about the debugging concepts which are in UiPath Studio. And that's it for this video. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you have any other doubts, please do mention them in the comment section below. And if there is any other suggestions for the videos to make, that will be really appreciated. And thanks for watching.